Hi there, we are the Money Dogs from the Money Archetypes from the Netherlands. This is my colleague, her name is?
Annelies van Rijkenvorsel from Nijmegen, the Netherlands.
Netherlands, and I'm Ofkie Tekens, also from the Netherlands. I'm a Jungian therapist and a transformational teacher. I will introduce myself and tell something about my work, and after this, Annelies van Rijkenvorsel, my colleague, is sitting next to me. She will tell you all about this new game we developed together, and this is about these money archetypes. Wow, this is exciting. You will see us every Wednesday at 9 a.m. Pacific time, 12 noon New York time, 5 p.m. London time, and 6 p.m. Paris, Amsterdam, Copenhagen, and Berlin. So join us every day on Wednesday, every week, 12 weeks after each other, and we tell you all about these money archetypes. But to understand these money archetypes, I want to start with our conversation, and afterwards Annelies will take it over from me, and we give some examples about these archetypes. Now, what are archetypes? Archetypes are the mirror of our soul. We have all those inner personalities in us. Isn't that true, Annelies?
For sure. For sure.
Yeah, we have a lot of them. So I made a game last summer about these archetypes and talents, and our beautiful cards inside of them. They are designed by Lisa Rutte from the Netherlands, from Amsterdam. They are really very colorful, and these archetypes are rooted in the collective conscious, subconscious. They help you to connect with your soul, so with your heart and with your intuition. So everybody has archetypes. We all have, but most people don't know them. They are all hidden in their treasure box. So my mission is to help people to open their treasure box, and you can see which archetypes, which treasures are there. So that means that in the future you will take more decisions with your heart, in line with your mission. So this is for a more fulfilling life. These archetypes, there's also a manual in the book, and you can see all those archetypes. We have a light side and a shadow side, and there's also a description of the designer. So you see, we are hidden our archetypes and our talents in the treasure box. We know already a bit about our inner gold. It's outside of the box, and Annelies will tell you much more about our inner gold and the money archetypes. And with these archetypes, there's a dragon on the box, and he has his key in his mouth, so you have to get rid of him so you can take the key to open your treasure box. So this is really being on that journey. And the last 12 shows, I introduced some guests. They talk about the archetypes, and we want to do this again in the second series of 12 TV shows from A Week TV. So they will be seen all over the world, and we want to give them all the attention, these archetypes. So this treasure box is really playful, and one of my archetypes is also the jester. Do you also have a jester, Annelies?
I have, but he is more showing sometimes a shadow side.
Okay, that's interesting. So that's what I also want to explain. Thank you for remembering. These archetypes have this light side and the shadow side. What's the difference, Annelies? Can you explain what this is all about?
Well, the jester, when he's operating from his light side, he is very, very frivolous and very joyful and joking. But when it comes to the shadow side, I remember when I was a little girl and when my baby brother was born, I was also a kind of jester, but in a kind of mean way, you know?
Yeah. Like sister. Really nice. So, but I think I love to play with my jester. I will show you the card of the jester. It's funny, there are also some questions to talk about. There are families in America who take this archetype every day. And you ask to your daughter, do you want to take a card? So today it's the jester, and he makes really big fun, but he can also be in the shadow side, and then he's a bit meanful. That's what Annelies just explained. And I like to play, so this is why I make several games. And we also made this new game, the Money Archetypes. And it's all about taking your leadership. Get rid of your blocks and everything. that you really feel the queen in your own kingdom. And that's very hard. So it's all about leadership. Where is your power? Where are your archetypes? What are your qualities? And I think it's a good moment now that I ask Annelies to tell something about this other game we made. Can you show this beautiful box?
Yes, of course. Ofkia. Yes, we made this beautiful game about the money archetypes. Unlock your money blocks with the money block dogs. Mm-hmm. And this glittering box has 32 archetype cards, specifically money archetype cards. And I will show them shortly here. So for instance, we have the treasurer. Ofkia showed you the dragon on the treasure box, but with the money archetypes, it can be the treasurer what is on your money box. So she keeps the treasure closed so the money cannot come in. And as Ofkia told you that the archetypes are hidden in the subconscious, also those money archetypes are hidden in this subconscious. And by reconnecting with the subconscious, you can really start a conversation with them as you can do with the archetypes and really see what you lack in business. So when you really encounter some problems in business, like lack of clients or struggle with the money flow, you really can see in the subconscious by connecting with your inner kingdom where your treasure room is hidden and how the situation is in this treasure room. And you really can reorder those money archetypes so you can get back the money flow.
Wow, this sounds very exciting, isn't it? It's really very helpful, I think, for people with problems, for starting entrepreneurs, or maybe also for personal problems. Maybe when you have fear or something like that. We are looking to all the subjects for the visitors, the clients we will ask for the interview. Yeah? So yes. Can you show you this beautiful box? And there's also a little book.
We have a manual with it as well, indeed. Yeah. So, and in this manual, it's written how you can use the money archetypes, because you can use them in several ways. You can use them by yourself and on a daily basis that you pick a card and just ask yourself this business related question and see what kind of answer you get from the money archetype. But this manual comes also with 52 money block themes. So every week, you can just pick one theme and see from yourself which archetypes can help you just dissolving this block. So you can really break through your upper limits and reach that next level in business.
And when you talk about this next level, Annelies, can you explain what you exactly mean with that? Do you have a real experience yourself so people can understand better maybe?
My own experience?
Yes.
Yes, of course. It's I'm still a career counselor at the university in Nijmegen, and I'm a career counselor for the past decade. So I guided more than 3,000 students toward a purposeful life and a purposeful career. But then at a certain moment, I just recognized that I am not born for a 9-to-5 job, meaning like, you know, sometimes I have very much energy in the evening or a lack of energy in the morning. So me fitting in a kind of box or having to work in a certain way, what people expect from me, it's quite difficult for a person like me who is multi-passionate about many things.
Mm. So what do you miss in your job at this moment, Annelies?
What I miss? Well, what I miss is this freedom, this kind of, you know, being able to work when I want to work, in the way I want to work. So it is always in a day job, maybe in a kind of structure, when you have to work in a kind of structure, you have to follow this structure. And, you know, maybe other people expect from you to work in a certain way. And if you have to adapt yourself to a kind of structure, what is not uniquely yours, then you adapt also yourself. So your hidden potential can maybe not flourish in those kind of circumstances.
I think this will be the case by a lot of persons, don't you think so?
I guess so, and maybe they're not even aware of this. But mm-hmm. when you really become honest to yourself, like, is this really the one thing I want to do, or at least for me, of course, I still love guiding those students toward this, this career. And it's very, you know, you feel grateful every day. But for me, the question came like, okay, I'm now almost 44. Is this the job I want to do?
Yeah, I understand that. I recognize this story very much, Annelies. I really recognize this story. When I was a teacher, I also work with children, and I thought every day, wow, I have to talk this story. I tell this story about grammatics every day. So this was the moment also that I want to quit. And then at that moment, I started with Jungian psychology. And I mentioned that it was more interesting than to give these lessons my whole life. So I really understand your feeling. So I think these cards can be very helpful to help you with this change, life-changing, life-shifting thing. So you don't like this anymore so much. Is this something you want to do? What archetype can help you and other people to make that shift, or to be honest to yourself and say, wow, I don't like this anymore. I want to quit.
Well, the thing is, you do not have to switch immediately. I mean, it can be just slowly, but so it starts really with like finding out what archetypes are hidden inside the core of your soul, as I
great
archetypes really would like to manifest. Some maybe there are archetypes who are undernourished, or who will tell you like, okay, I really would like to manifest something. And for me, it was very clear that the writer, when I met the writer,
story. People want to know. Please share it. Yeah. Nice.
Yeah. Well, to the listeners to this show, you know, I know Ofkje this year for 8 years.
The writer, wow, so long.
Yes, and 8 years ago, I followed the training to become this certified young talent coach. So since I was working with those students, I really wanted to develop myself more in personal development and talent development.
Wow, yeah.
So when I was Googling on the internet, I came across the site of the Game of Gifts, and that they were starting a training that March to become a certified young talent coach. And I immediately knew, okay, this is it. So in this training of 4 days, I got reconnected with my writer.
There he is, the writer.
And the writer was already there when I was a kid of 3 years old. When I was 3 years old, I wrote my first letter to my grandma. And language was always something I excelled in. So I had this kind of dream when I was young to become a writer. But then people start telling you, like, when you become a writer, you end up broke. It's very hard to earn your money by becoming a writer. So I kind of gave up this dream. And then in those days, when I got reconnected with the writer, he was there at the end of my at my game board. So it was really clear, like, okay, you still can become a writer, but it will take you a few years to come there. And he was sitting behind this desk, a very huge, large desk. And I was this little prince. And the chair was way too high for me. I could not climb on a chair or to even sit behind his desk.
I remember this story. Beautiful.
And then at a home, as an assignment, this home assignment we got, we had to write our own fairy tale, I remember. And
the exercise.
And I remember that I was just at home sitting down, just thinking what could I write about. And just my first fairy tale just came to life. Just really like kind of divine inspiration.
Yes.
And I decided later on, okay, I will reconnect with this writer more often. I will just start writing again. So I started to write little fairy tales. And in 2016, Prins Rattenplan, it's in Dutch. It's a story about a little prince who was capable of doing anything with his superpowers.
Wow.
Came superpowers. Into existence.
Superpowers. And the writer was your superpower, your archetype.
Yes.
And what kind of book did you make? Can you show us? Do you have it there?
I have it there, but it's in my closet.
Okay.
I don't have it nearby, so.
Okay. We can show it later. No problem.
We can show it later.
So this is really, really interesting story. So you really discover this talent, this archetype, and then you make that connection again. And that's also about these money archetypes. We want to dance, we want to draw, we want to write, but our parents said, don't do that, because you can't earn your money with that. And then a lot of dreams will disappear. So it was wonderful to see, because I was there at that moment, that your dream came true and you started with writing. And we reconnect last year again. And we talked about this writer and how magical it was that he was there. And at the end, we made new plans, because
yes,
we think children and students and adults deserve it. Also to make their book or their whatever, or music or things. And it can be very special that you can earn your money with that. But it's also about feeling happy. So these archetypes bring your dreams come true.
And also, if I can add to this, you know, sometimes we live in a time where things do not exist yet. So in my time, for instance, we did not have social media or copywriting or whatever. So, you know, indeed, by that time, I wanted to become a writer. It was only by publishing books.
Yes.
But right now, in this time, you know, with all this content for the websites, etc., you know, we live in a complete different time.
Different professions also. So it take a lot of guts from you to start this, and you did very well. So you earned your money also with writing books now. And what made it, what was your plan? Because I remember a wonderful story, what happened also in this subconscious about this sultan.
About the sultan, yes. About the
sultan. Do you have the card there, Annelies?
Yeah, I have the card here.
Yeah? Do you want to tell the listeners, the watchers, to this beautiful, powerful sultan who's sitting there? Yeah?
Yeah.
It's magic.
The story about the sultan, I call it a brilliant story, because in 2016, I collapsed at the campsite. You have to know the story as well, otherwise you might not see the relevance of this all. But I collapsed at the campsite and I got hospitalized for several weeks. And when I collapsed at the campsite, the only thing I remember about this is that I really entered a kind of other world. It was really serene, very peaceful, very, very quiet. And then suddenly a voice told me, you do not belong here. And I got flashed back to Earth. So from the moment I opened my eyes, I realized that I had been in a complete other reality.
Wow.
So some people call it a near-death experience. I don't know if it was like that. It was just...
Sounds exciting.
Amazing. Yeah, but it was really, you know, really peaceful. And I was just floating there in a very bright, light, peaceful world.
Yeah.
And I got hospitalized. In the hospital, I met Laura, and that's how my children books came into existence, because she was a brilliant illustrator. And we started a collaboration together, just also to pass time in the hospital. And after I got dismissed from the hospital, I just decided myself, okay, I will reconnect with my archetypes again, because I also realized that I was drifted away from my soul purpose again, you know, that I collapsed had to do with a lot of stress as well.
Yeah.
A lot of stress I had from work, young kids, you know, so everything. I was just exhausted as well.
But people will recognize this for sure. Yeah.
Yes. So I decided to do this imagination sessions again on a kind of daily basis. And then in May 2017,
What did you mean with that? Is imagination sessions? It was frozen a bit. So can you explain about this imagination? Because a lot of watchers don't know what it is.
Yes. So when you meet the archetypes, you use this imagination technique, and it's a kind of meditation. So you really go with your attention towards, you dive deep into kind of inside yourself, and with your eyes closed, you can just really see your own inner kingdom. And then you see yourself in this kingdom like a queen or a king or a little prince or a little princess. And in this kingdom, you can meet your inner talents. So you can meet your talents. So, and they will tell you why they are there for you.
And why do you have to close your eyes? How does that work, the processing?
I myself do it with my eyes closed, so I do not get distracted. You can also do it with your eyes wide open. Some people also can immediately see their inner kingdom just with their eyes open, but then maybe you get distracted with
Can I explain better when it's about this conscious and this subconscious, that you can be aware of more information for people who are listening now? It's about you go to a deeper layer to get more information. Is that for sure? Is that true?
Yeah, yeah. It's like that. Yes. It's what Einstein already said, actually. Yeah, Einstein had this quote, like, a problem can never be solved from the level it was once created. So it is a way to go to a kind of deeper layer, a kind of, an invisible power we all have inside of us. And all the information, all the answers to your problems are just hidden there.
Yeah, so there's archetypes are kind of superpowers we have, like you see an iceberg, you have the ice above the water, but the most ice is under the water. So this is the spiritual part of us we want to know more about. We can get answers with the brains, so we go to a deeper layer. That's what you
exactly
mean. Yeah,
exactly.
Right.
Yes. Wow. And so it happened, I was sitting there in my own inner tavern, I call it, and I was sitting there with my talents, like with the ambassador and the storyteller. The innkeeper was there, he just lit a fire, the cook, he just cooked a delicious meal. And we just had really a very, very nice just evening. And I was sitting there as a king with my talents, and I was so pleased and I was so content. And I actually realized that evening, that was the first time in my life that I really, really felt really pleased. Just like super content. It could not be better.
And then, what was this about? Was it just a feeling or just...
Yeah, it was really a feeling. Really like just... very hard to explain, but it's just this really content feeling, like this is just most perfect circumstance you can ever have in your life.
About this moment, I think.
I'm there to tell you about this moment. So yeah. That it was that very moment, from that very super pleased content feeling, that just someone knocked on the door of my inner kingdom. And it was late at night, it was 10 o'clock, and we looked at each other like, we do not expect anyone. So the innkeeper, he opened the door, and from the same bright light as I was in when I collapsed at the campsite, the bright light was standing in the door. In this bright light stood the Sultan, just like he was coming from that same other reality as I had been. And just he stood there in his most beautiful colors, you know, with the clothes with most beautiful colors. And so we invited him. We were gazing with open mouth because we never ever saw such a beautiful figure. So we invited him in and we asked him, you know, who are you? And he said, well, I'm the Sultan. I'm a merchant from the Middle East. I bought my ware in the East and I'm on my way to the West to sell them. And
I show the car. Do you have it there?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's really wonderful. Look at those colors. You, wow.
Yes. And then he said, he said, I'm just looking for a place to stay overnight. So we said, yeah, well, you can stay overnight here. Welcome. And that evening, so we put an extra chair. And that evening, he told me his 10 money secrets.
What is that? The 10 money secrets.
Wow. Yes. How he became a rich man. 10 money secrets.
Tell us all about, Annelies.
About the money secrets.
Yes.
Well, I don't... there's a free ebook or also a course related to it. But one of the money...
We send it. Yeah.
So one of the money archetypes was the first one. So because when he came to us, he had beautiful scarves and beautiful jewelry with him. Really beautiful, beautiful stuff. And he said, like, money secret one is, like, you might think that I earn my money with the scarves, but it's the jewelry what brings the money in. So money secret one was, like, if you sell a product or a service, just make sure you have an extra revenue stream so you can upsell something. So he said, all the ladies who buy a scarf from me wants to have the jewelry with it as well. So and in this way he told me 9 other money secrets.
Wow.
Yeah, and then he
happened?
He turned to me and he said, together with the writer, I'm your inner millionaire.
Wow.
And what's I was that? Like,
inner millionaire.
My what? I was like, my what? I thought I misunderstood. So he repeated very calmly. He said, together with the writer, I'm your inner millionaire. And I said, what do you mean by that?
Yeah.
So he showed in full detail. And he said, write a book, sell it for $10, so for $10 or 10 euros, mm-hmm. sell 100,000 copies and you'll have a million. And I had to laugh because, you know, the math is very simple.
Yeah.
And he said, well, he said, that's your divine $1 million plan.
Ooh. That sounds great, Annelies. And I think this
he said, and yeah. then he left.
Yeah. So, yes. So this was his story. Yeah. Oh.
This was the story.
Mm-hmm.
This was the story. And so then the next day, I did not have a notebook with me. So the next day I wrote all the money secrets down. And I thought, well, if I have this inner millionaire within me, everyone should have an inner millionaire. I mean, with those archetypes all hidden in our subconscious, the collective subconscious means that there is an inner millionaire for every one of us. But he was very, also one of his secrets was, he was very clear on that. He said also, when you have a day job, you will never make a million. Mm-mm. But, you know, so start your own business and you will be able to do so.
Yeah.
So then I thought, okay. And then that was 3 years ago. And then that's the following months, you know, I traveled with the Sultan to his world because he was living in a complete other world. And I met all kind of other archetypes. And
so there it starts all again.
Like, you know, it was really the Sultan was living in a pyramid in the desert. And when I was in the desert, for instance, I met a nomad.
There she is. Can you see it?
The nomad. And the nomad, she really showed me the land, the way to the land of milk and honey. So
with the golden mountains, yoo-hoo.
Yeah, because in with the golden, you see here the golden mountains, because it was also before I could go with the Sultan to this new world, I had a talk with my philosopher from the talent from the Ophicus game, and the philosopher told me, like, go with the Sultan. My time is gone. So go with the Sultan. But be careful for the golden mountains. And I asked him, you know, what do you mean with be careful? He said, I only can tell you be careful for the golden mountains. So when I traveled with the Sultan and when I saw these golden mountains there, because they were just there, you know, my curiosity won it from fear. So at a certain moment, I thought, I just want to go there. So I knew I had to travel the desert for it. I knew that. So I just grabbed a lot of water, a lot of food. Mm. And I just went on by myself with no guards, whatever. I just went by myself. Mm. And so it was that I met Nomad, because she was living in this, do you call it oase? Or, you know, with this green, this in the desert, this Texas, place where you can rest.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah, and there I met her, and she said, I will show you the way to the land of milk and honey. And then it was just 10 steps away.
Yeah. We can't hear you now, Annelies.
There was no fence.
Sorry, nothing. it was frozen, your screen, so.
I was frozen.
Yeah, so maybe you can repeat the last two sentences, please.
Yeah, this land of milk and honey was only 10 steps away.
Mm.
So it was deserts and only a land of coins, only coins.
Wow. Yeah. So this sounds very interesting. I tell you this to the watchers now, because what is happening with Annelies now? She's talking with the money archetypes. So this is this beautiful box we made this year it has been published.
This year.
With this manual, with this money archetypes. Instead of the other box, these are 32 money archetypes. And she explained that we can go dive very deep and talk with these money archetypes. And then you get that information that's deep down in the subconscious and the collective consciousness. So really interesting to share your story to everybody, Annelies.
And maybe it's interesting to share as well what it means, you know, because maybe I had this vision, but that then how to translate it to reality, huh? Because when you talk kind of with this energy or with the personalities you meet, it's a kind of symbolic language.
Yes. I hear that you have been encouraged maybe also by this money archetypes you met, that they encourage you to write this book.
When I met the Sultan and when he told me that was May 2017, I absolutely got encouraged to go to write that book because the children book was not there yet. So what I did the few days later, I called my illustrator and I said, Laura, you know, what I know now is just we have to publish that book. We just have to. And so we did, and it was published in November. In November that same year, and the year after we published our part two.
Wow.
Yeah, so that encouraged me to go to write, but also it encouraged me just seeing this land of milk and honey, or just being there, meant like all the money you need or all the money you deserve or whatever is just there. It's maybe not in your reality yet, but it is just there.
Yeah, it's all about this treasure box again. I have it here with this. All those coins, when you see those archetypes, a lot of coins. So how fun is it that you can do all this with these coins and have this fun to see what are your possibilities? Because we hide in our things, we have hidden our talents, and it's good that you open up the treasure box so you can see which archetypes are yours, because we all have them, and we have 74 at least. So, and in this money archetype game, you can unlock your money blocks. And that's why we present each other. We are the healers. We are money docs. We help people to unlock their money blocks. So, and this is very special also that there is in this book, these money blocks, because we block a lot of things because we learned that in our inner childhood. I see that every week in my speaking with my clients about their childhood. They have a lot of skills, talents, archetypes, but they have forgotten or they are not allowed. So it's good that you can help people. We help people every day to unlock their issues, their childhood problems. So Annelies, can you tell me some more or to the people about this all those 52 money books we wrote them in this book.
We have 52 themes, yes.
Yeah, and one important money archetype is also this procrastinator, difficult word. She weighs everything very carefully in order to make a good decision. How often is that true, that when we want to make a decision, it's very difficult because we don't know, is this the good one or the other one? And we feel guilty sometimes, or there's a bit of shame. Or can you tell us more about these money blocks, Annelies, how they determined our life?
Yeah, because, you know, we have many things what can just stand in our way. Yes. Just to fulfill our potential, but also in earning money.
Yes.
So maybe, you know, and most of those money blocks, as you told you, stem from childhood. So for instance, not being good enough, or, you know, that your potential could not be used in school, or that you were not good in some things. You can keep this feeling of not being good enough. And also
when you're an adult too, you can still feel it when you're
five. Exactly.
You're not good enough, you don't deserve anything, then you can feel it today.
But even by, for instance, putting an offer out, you know, when you have still this feeling of not being good enough, you always might think, okay, my offer might not be good enough, or what people might not think I'm not good enough, or I will never be able to deliver what I have to deliver. And it all will mean that you will just procrastinate putting that offer out. So this procrastinator, you see, you're really sitting on this crossroads and really sitting in her own way. then it's really, you know, then it's really important to have this conversation with the procrastinator, like, what exactly do you need?
Yeah.
And maybe it's just support. Yeah. Or maybe just comfort, you know, mm-hmm. or but when you really know what she needs, mm-hmm. Or maybe, you know, maybe she needs to, maybe she's very anxious.
Yeah.
So when you know exactly what she needs, you can give it to her and see what needs to be done to get this money block. Well, just fade away.
All those people with these blocks and has been told you're a bad piano player. And when you're later, when you have your own piano and you try it on, say, I'm still very good in playing the piano. But you have been told you're not. So it's good to stay and explore your qualities and solve these money blocks. Can you give a few examples? So we started with this game. We already worked for years with the archetypes. But this new archetypes are so beautiful design again. Another one is very interesting is the enlighter. So when you put more light on it and you invite the enlighter, it can be so big lucky moment for you that you can see that it is possible to use these qualities, these archetypes, and you can have your purpose and your goal in life. You can reach that for sure. Mm-hmm. You had some experiences with other clients, Annelies, do you want to share your personal story? Also very interesting, because mm-hmm. this TV show is about knowing of Cutikens and Annelies van Rijkenvorstel. So you can meet us and we tell something personal stories, but also from our clients, just to give that credibility that you know it is possible to work with this archetype, how they work, how you can go to the deeper layer to share a card every day or every week and buy the books and use them yourself. Yeah. Please.
Yeah, because I had lately a client and she is called the Cruising Lady. She organized cruises every year, mm-hmm. and she had one big mission that she wanted once that a full ship with only entrepreneurs cruise in the Atlantic Ocean.
Yeah.
But she was based in the Netherlands, and as you know, the Netherlands is not that big. So for her, it was really difficult. Like, okay, how do I reach those internationals, those international entrepreneurs who want to come to travel with me?
Yeah.
So what happened is that we went into this imagination with her and I really asked her, okay, can you see the ship with money located? And she saw clearly the ship with money located, but the harbor was too small. Mm. So the ship with money was there, but the harbor where the ship could come to land just was too small. So first it was the harbor master. The harbor master, we have also the harbor master as one of our archetypes. He told the architect, you know, you have to make a new fundament for this harbor. Mm-hmm. And so we made the harbor, we made it bigger so mm-hmm. the ship could arrive. Mm-hmm. And then with her in this imagination, we made a kind of plan like, how, because sometimes I also get then this divine inspiration, it's like, how do we get those internationals on board? And it was really like, okay, just do not cross the Atlantic Ocean, but maybe take a cruise to another destination, that the ship just arrives in different harbors in different countries, that people can come on board on different timelines.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so,
the harbor master was helping you in this case.
Yeah, the harbor master and the architect was helping her in this case.
Yeah.
Yes.
So,
and then she could become really the captain of the ship, you know, it's really like, this is my ship. And
So this is, they're really funny stories, what happened. But you see also, there's also divine inspiration. That also coming through. So it's a combination from a bit of magic, maybe. Can you say that, Annelies?
Yeah, kind of miracle, miracle worker or whatever. It's just this, this divine, like the Sultan came, you know, sometimes I get other information, what just comes through me. Mm. And then you get these goosebumps, you know, and then you know that you're on the right track. Yeah. Yeah. You might recognize this as well.
Yes. Yeah. So this leadership is very important, that you feel you're on track, what you say. Yeah. It's about this kingdom, and it can be a leader of an orchestra or a king or a queen or a prince or a princess. And this leader, he has also a light side and a shadow side. And you see, he's designed here a bit in the shadow side. He takes the chords and he said what he likes to do. So follow the leader. So it's an invitation to yourself to work with these archetypes and feel your own leadership. And we as coaches and therapists, we walk with you with this archetype card, the companion. Yeah, so it's only walking along you as a person and help you. So these money archetypes, you also can see this is about this merchant to do your business, and your business gets stuck, or you just started with your business and you see this design of this pig earning this money and put it all in his head of this merchant. And I think it's really good to look to yourself and to your business with these money archetypes. So what you just heard about this harbor master, it was very helpful for her, for this lady in Netherlands, who has a new $1 million plan. That's what you talk about. She met her in the
city. Yeah. 4 hours we found out about her $1 million plan. That's what's her $1 million plan. Yes.
And you do this in one afternoon so people can understand, or a few hours or 1 hour. How quick does it go, this meeting with this inner millionaire?
Well, it just depends, of course, because sometimes there is still this lot of childhood pain. So sometimes you have first to heal that part. Mm-hmm. But I'm working on a 3-month program that in 1 month you can heal this childhood pain. The second one, you meet your genius, because I say the inner millionaire is always related to your genius. Huh? It's mm-hmm. not, you shoot this in a $1 million plan is uniquely yours. So it's
everybody's unique, but what is a genius? Can you explain?
A genius, yes. Well, it's maybe a bit of hard to explain, but I will try. But but your genius is really this innate talent in you, what you are born with. So this talent, what is already with you there in early childhood. So when you really go back to your childhood and really untangle this, your childhood story and your childhood passions, then it's really clear already what might be your genius. So in my case, it was this excelling in language, writing, but also telling stories. When I was very young, I was already telling stories. So in this way, you can really find out about this innate talent, about your genius. It's really this talent. What
the DNA. It's a kind of DNA. And you go back to that.
Yeah, might be. Yes, to your DNA. And I say the inner millionaire is also hidden in the core of your soul. So it is just, you know, it's like a match with two. You know, like a genius and the inner millionaire makes, makes everything possible. In fact,
So it's important, I think, that we tell our watchers that they can open up to these archetypes. We can invite them, and we create in this way, by choosing these archetypes or the money archetypes, you're in the dream team. They're your friends you have always with you, so you can ask them. And they learn you also to be a bit more mild for yourself, not to be too much a perfectionist, because perfectionism is also a money block. When you're never happy with who you are, it's also about self-love. It's about self-acceptance. To see that you say, yes, I'm really pretty good piano player or a drawer or whatever you want to be. Yes. But this is also about the self-confidence. It's all those blocks, all those issues, fear, guilt, come most of the time from your childhood, but it isn't necessary. But it's also to know very well that's also about abundance. We have a lot of them, but some people need to learn how to express themselves. So then they can feel the abundance and they have the guts to see and celebrate what they have and who they are. And I'm really curious about your reactions for people watching us. to maybe it's the first time on release day they meet their archetypes and see what is what are their inner friends. So I hope it is a bit clear. Maybe we can invite you also that we will have another 11 shows, and we made a schedule. Maybe it will change a bit, but there will be people who will explain and learn you more about these blocks you can have. So there are a few issues in your life by a few people. We have invited a few people. You know somebody about his soul words? Can you tell something about that, Annelies?
Yeah, that is someone who really can say what kind of soul words you can use to attract your clients. Yeah. So we also have the seducer as one of our money archetypes. Yeah. She has the magnet around her neck. She's really attracting her clients. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And this person really can tell more about what kind of words you can use in your content to attract clients.
Yes. So, and I contribute with a person also in an interview about high sensitivity, because high sensitivity is also difficult to earn your money in your company when you have this high sensitivity. And I have contact with somebody who want to learn you more how to fix your money with social media, because you need some knowledge also to have more bliss in your biz. And sometimes it's difficult also with your own personality, and you have to forgive people. So we have also someone who talks about forgiveness. Family constellation, celebration, soul words, self-love. And we have a woman also, she's from the East, and we will talk also about money in the East, how that works. It's completely different than in the West. And I hope, you will, when you have some questions, put it in our chat box or give us a mail. We are the Money Docs, so we have a wonderful website, is www.moneyblockdocs.com. Do we say it well?
www.moneyblockdoc.com.
Oh yeah, Money Block Doc, that's it. I have dyslexia, so.
We are the Money Block Docs. We the website is Money Block Doc.
Yeah, Money Block Doc. So this is it, and
people can sign up for a webinar.
Yes, for sure. And yes, we can order also the box, this money archetype box, and we have related games to the archetypes, the Archetype Quest, and that's a 7-module training to become Archetype Quest coach. So there are several possibilities, and we try to do every TV show you do an offer. And so we have a bundle of sessions to work with this inner millionaire and his money archetypes with us as the Money Docs. You can buy also the books about the Money Block Docs, and you can reach out for us. We will put in the mail underneath our show, our websites, so you can reach and talk with us and book a session if you like to do that. But the next 11 shows, we will invite beautiful people, and we do interviews with them. We show the cards so you can be connected with them. And we will show you how you do this imagination, this meditation, to meet this inner millionaire and this money archetypes and archetypes. So you have this own feeling deep inside. You get your information from this deeper layer, and we will show you how you can do that. So for now, thank you very much for joining us. And we were the Money Docs, Annelies van Rijkenvorsel of Getekens from the Netherlands. Thank you for watching us. You will see us next week on Wednesday, 6 p.m. I will take it 9 a.m. Pacific time, 12 noon New York time, 5 p.m. London time, and 6 p.m. Paris, Amsterdam, London, and Berlin. Of Copenhagen and Berlin, sorry. So thank you for watching us.
Thank you very much for attending.
You will see us next week. Bye-bye.
Bye. Bye-bye.